One of the things which has aided our survival over the centuries is a kind of steely determination. When we focus on something, a belief, a goal, something which helps us move forward, something that we can concentrate our energies and our efforts on in order to make some sort of progress, however slow it might be. There's a downside, of course, the black and the white side to so many things, if not all things. If we have such focus, steely determination, let's call it, we tend to blot out some things. We tend to make premature judgments and put labels on things. And then, once you put a label on something, you tend only to read the label and not reevaluate what it is or how it might have changed or grown or learned. So in the progress we've made to get to where we are, both in our lives and in our history, we have had to have a grim kind of determination to move forward, to find the things which mean the most to us, focus on them, and therefore minimize or rule out some other things which of themselves might be just as deserving but are not within the pantheon, the scope of what we have decided to focus on. This is a hindrance to relations many, many times. Relations with anything that falls beyond the normal borders of what we've come to call our inner circle of understanding. I'd like to think that it's profoundly possible to redesign this living room of thought in which our brain decides to plunk down and most reside on the comfortable couches that we've constructed for it, the familiar routines we've made for it to run. I don't know if this contains any significant portion or measure of ease for us to ascertain, as ease is not part of the equation. Anything worth it is going to be difficult. A lot of the times we'll construct something that is the realm of our understanding, that is part machination, part based on natural reality. And we operate within this. We use it as a periscope to see our future. Of course, you know, the danger of using a periscope is you're missing everything that's outside of its range. And even if you're doing a wise sweep, as not everyone does, to see the landscape, you're missing whatever's going on when you're not looking at it. That's the point. So there's this general mindset to think that progress only resides within, and we must manifest it without. We must show progress rather than assume simultaneously around the world there's progress being made. Now, it's rather rare to find somebody who can say, you know, regardless of my own progress, regardless of what I've discovered, regardless of what I've learned, I defer to the long-standing greater progress of others. Perhaps this is a view that some would call scholarly, but it's not really scholarly. It has nothing to do with intelligence as it does with wisdom. So As agoraphobic as I am, part of my intention as I've gone through life is to see some of the world. And when I was younger, I spent over a month on the other side of the world, in China and Mongolia and Japan, living with families. And more recently, discovering my own country, going from coast to coast, basically, over the course of 3 weeks. It's not something that can be suddenly summarized. You know, you can't get back and take the keys out of the ignition of the car and then say, blah, 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 that's how it is. No, you might try, you might be tempted to, but it really takes some period of sitting down and thinking and absorbing in order to come at a conclusion or a summary that is anywhere near the mark. So the road sometimes is like layers of thought, and traveling it frequently produces after images. Just like if you've been driving the highway all day, sometimes you'll still see those white line segments moving before your eyes as you lie to sleep at night. I think knowledge is similar. If you attempt to acquire a significant amount of knowledge, and significant is very, very relative, we're talking about the scope of what we can absorb. So, a little fragment, a little fraction within the sphere of knowledge. If we make a conscious effort to learn as much as we can, we suffer, we endure, and we enjoy the marvelous visitations of these after images, these ghosts, these phantoms of it which come, which one night they might present theory, they might present elucidation into something which you had not previously formed in that measure. And another night they might present torment, they might tell you how little you actually know and how hopeless it all is if you are endeavoring to know more. So much of it is about understanding and our capacities. Our evolution has made us focus. Our evolution has given us a kind of tunnel vision. And what we see within this is a very minute amount of what is actually out there, because it allows us to operate, it allows us to move forward. Sometimes, if our senses are overwhelmed, instead of moving forward, the wisest decision is to stop and try, you know, just to attempt to absorb everything that's coming at you. And of course, as you're doing that, you might actually be moving backward without knowing it, simply for lack of forward progress. So just a little consideration, just a little interesting thing perhaps to ponder, to think about in your free time. Is our rigidity, is our innate instinct, self-preservation even, so that we can actually meet whatever future awaits for us by closing certain doors, you know, like a laser beam? It starts off as a flashlight. And then you say, well, the light's not reaching far enough. So we have to create a lens that sort of focuses, and we have to shut off these other areas so that all we can do is reach this narrow point. And that's what's going to allow us to gain this little tidbit of wisdom within the whole sphere, within the whole world of wisdom that there might be gained. Otherwise, at best, it's incomplete fragments, and for every piece that's missing, we could very well make a wrong assumption to fill in the blank. I'm going to assume that helpfulness is by degrees. I'm going to allow myself the luxury of thinking that whatever usefulness we have is not just to ourselves, but in proportion as we learn and as we grow, as we attain wisdom, which at times can be so different from intelligence. See, people who extol intelligence above wisdom are people who are more conditioned to exist in rarefied climes. Wisdom is more of an all-purpose thing. If we can attain more of that, then guess what? Like a dog on a leash, intelligence will follow.